Now that we understand what the matrix is and how it relates to a linear transformation, we can talk about matrix norms. Remember, a norm is just a measure of the length, of the magnitude of the object to which it's applied. So in this particular case, the input is an m by n matrix, out comes a real number, and the function has to obey a certain rules. It has to be positive definite, it has to be homogeneous, and it has to obey the triangle inequality. In the next units, we are going to discuss a bunch of different matrix norms. And what we're going to find out is that some of those matrix norms have nice properties. For example, some matrix norms have the property that in measuring the magnitude of the matrix, that magnitude somehow has meaning when it comes to the magnitude of the underlying linear transformation. There are other norms that are merely easy to compute. What do we mean by easy to compute? Well, a matrix is typically an m by n array of entries. It would be nice to be able to compute its magnitude in order m times n time, order m times n computations. Okay, so we're going to consider those easy to compute. There are other norms that are differentiable. In other words, the function that defines the norm is differentiable. Why is that important? Well, if we want to talk about optimality, it'd be nice to be able to differentiate and set to zero, or at least in some way talk about optimality, and typically a function being differentiable helps us with that. Right? Now, here's the thing. It would be nice if there was one matrix norm to rule them all. It'd be nice if there was one matrix norm that has all of these nice properties so we could just use it and have it over with. The problem is, there is no norm that has all of these nice properties, at least not in the general case of an m by n matrix. So we're going to continuously find ourselves looking for that norm that works for this particular situation. Now, fortunately, just like we have equivalence of norms for vector norms, we have equivalence of norms for matrix norms. So at least once we find a norm that works for our situation, if a matrix happens to be large in that norm, then we know it's large in other norms. And if a matrix happens to be small in that norm, it's also small in all the other norms. All right, so let's go and learn a bit about matrix norms.